Now we will look for the horizontal navigation bars and the vertical navigation bars. Okay, so we have seen how to add the tabs, right? These were the basic tabs. Now how do navigation bars look like is like, so these are the navigation bars, right? These are the navigation bars and these were the basic tabs which you can add in your web page, right? So to add this navigation bars, we have this navigation tab, okay, and we have the class navigation bar, and for horizontal navigation bars we have to add this navigation expand, okay, and for vertical navigation bars we have nothing, basic thing. Now for horizontal navigation bars, similarly, in simpler way, we can add the UL li text and li for navigation item, anchor link for navigation link, just we have added in navigation tabs. Similarly for second link, we have the navigation item and the navigation link, okay. But instead of navigation tab, as we have seen in this case, navigation tabs, there was navigation tabs, right? But in case of navigation bars, we have the nav bar nav. Okay, this is the only difference, and for horizontal we have this expand and for vertical we have nothing. So let's see this in practical. Okay, so what we will do now is we create the navigation at the top of this web page. So here I am adding the navigation. Okay, inside this we will add basic UL li text, how many items we want. Like we want home, we want services, we want login, register. These are the basic navigation items, right? Now we have to add the class name here, a class name here, a class navigation item. And inside this we have the anchor link, okay, and the navigation link here,
powering off.
Similarly for this we can add the navigation item, and for the services we add the anchor link because we want it to be a link, right? It should be clickable. So we have the navigation link, okay. Similarly for the third one, we will quickly add the navigation item, and for login register we add the link, navigation link. Now the only thing we have to remember here is we have to add the nav bar. What is the name? Nav bar nav, okay, for UL. And for navigation class we have this navigation bar, navigation expand sm. So this is a class name. You don't need to remember all the things, but if you understood the basic theory about how to add the navigation tab bars or navigation bars or navigation tabs in Bootstrap, you can refer the class name and go ahead, right? You will get the notes for this. You can refer the class name and you know how to add the navigations in your web page. So you can refer the classes and go ahead, right? So I never remember the classes, class names, but I know how to add the things on the web page. So I refer them and create my own things, create my things. Okay, so let's see. Here we go. We have the three tabs here. Now suppose if I add one more here, li tag, and I give it a style as float right. upcoming float right there. Okay, so this is how we can add the vertical horizontal navigation bar, and if I remove this, it will come in vertical navigation format, right? So this was about the navigation bars, and to add the drop down inside this navigation bar, we have simpler. Similarly, like we have added the ally tag with class navigation item, and for anchor link we have added this navigation link, and but now we want a drop down. We have to add the extra class drop down, and as we have seen the data toggle property drop down, and we have to add the list of drop down menu. Simple. Okay, so let's try this here. Now we will add one drop down here. So nav item. Okay. Here I will add the anchor link. Now there is a navigation item, right? Okay, now we want to add a drop down, so I will add a drop down here, and we'll create the drop down menu first. So I add the drop down menu here, drop down menu here. Okay, and inside the drop down I will add some link 1, anchor link, link 2, right? We have drop down. Okay, now we have to create the let's run this, and the nav bar expand SM here. Okay, now the drop down link is not appearing here, right? So we have to add the link. Just we have added the link for this ally tag, we have to add the drop down link also. So I name it as drop down. Okay, and we have to give the data toggle property as drop down, right? And the href is hash. Okay, the basic thing. And there is data toggle property also. Let's run this and see. Okay, nothing is happening. I give the data toggle property here. Now the arrow has come and the links are coming properly, right? So in this way we can add the drop down. Now to make it functional, like we have added the drop down but the links were not appearing, the links are appearing inline, right? So to drop down has this class, so the Bootstrap has this class drop down item. Okay, so the links will appear in a proper format. Okay, this data toggle is important. If we remove the data toggle from here, okay, if we remove the data toggle from here, the drop down will work, but it is not a proper UI. It is not displaying the proper UI with some arrow. So we have the data toggle class also. Using that class we can display the user friendly UI for the drop down. In this way we can add the drop downs. Now what if I remove this for vertical navigation bar? The drop down will appear here, right? And all the CSS hover effects are added by default. Okay, so this is the thing about drop downs in navigation bar.